Miss Deguito. Maia Santos-Deguito, ma'am. Do you know a certain Jason Go?
Sir, I understand. I already requested for the executive session. Everything will be disclosed there, Your Honor.
Mr. Lorenzo Tan?
Yes, Your Honor.
Do you know a certain Jason Go, a dealer in expensive cars?
Yes, Your Honor. He's a friend.
You know him?
Yes.
And is it true that Ms. Deguito was supposed to be the manager, designated to be the manager of RCBC, a branch in the Fort area, but upon the recommendation of Mr. Jason Go, she was put in the Jupiter branch. Am I correct?
That is the story I heard, Your Honor, but you know, I had nothing to do with, you know, choosing the branch for Ms. Deguito.
Then who chooses the branch head? And who can answer me then?
Sir, we have retail banking heads, district heads, and area heads that determine who would be the best.
Can you tell me the person who can answer my question that I just asked you?
I think the head of our retail bank who is in the room can answer that.
Is he here?
Yes, sir.
Please call him then so we can have my question answered.
His name is Mr. Raul Tan.
Please administer the oath to Mr. What's the name, please? Raul Tan, Comsec. Mr. Tan.
Mr. Tan, please raise your right hand. You solemnly swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in this investigation. Please take it. Thank you.
Please state your name and your position in RCBC.
I am Raul Victor Tan.
Closer to the mic, please.
I am Raul Victor Tan. I am presently the treasurer of RCBC, and I was formerly the head of retail banking.
Okay. Mr. Tan, is it true that Maia Santos-Deguito was supposed to be a branch manager at the Fort area, but instead, upon the prodding recommendation, call it whatever, representation of a certain Mr. Jason Go, she was designated as the RCBC Jupiter branch manager.
Yes, Your Honor, except that she was supposed to be assigned, I think, in Beacon branch.
Beacon branch.
In the Fort. Upon the recommendation of Mr. Jason Go, to our region head, Bridget Capina.
And who is this Mr. Jason Go that he can cause the designation of a branch manager? He's not part of RCBC, but he seems to be very powerful.
Mr. Senator, I believe he has large businesses which would help in bringing up the business of the branch.
I understand. He's a valued client of the branch.
I cannot disclose that, Your Honor.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. But anyway, it's clear enough.
Just to follow up on that.
Okay, Senator Recto.
He is not part of RCBC, but he is a valued client.
I cannot disclose that.
Maybe I can. So yes, he's a valued.
Ma'am, please identify yourself. So that's all right. Just so that the stenographers will be able to follow.
My name is Marcel Fernandez Estavillo, and he's a valued client of the bank. I apologize that I answered everybody so uneasy with the violation of bank secrecy, but yes,
uneasy with the violation of bank secrecy or the name Jason Go?
Not at all the name.
Okay,
sir.
Anyway, the point is this. No? Yes. So he is a valued client. He can make recommendations to the bank. Who sits where? To be branch manager?
Well, I understand his place of business is actually on Jupiter Street as well.
Okay, and who, if he made the recommendation, who approved it then?
Eventually, it went up to me, and it went up to our executive committee and the board.
So the board approved?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. What else do you know about Mr. Jason Go, Mr. Tan?
I have very little.
I can see Mr. Lorenzo Tan, you want to answer?
Oh.
How come you know Mr. Jason Go,
I've known him for a long time.
Please speak closer to the mic, sir.
Jason is known to a lot of people who live in the Makati area. They buy and sell their cars to him. And, you know, I've bought some traded cars from him. So when people want to buy new cars, they trade their old cars. And then they look for buyers for the old cars. So anyone who is, you know, into cars would know Mr. Go. You know, a lot of CEOs of corporations would also know him.
Is it standard in your bank, Mr. Tan, that private individuals, whether they be valued clients or not, but in this case, valued clients, and I suppose you are your valued client if you're a big depositor, can really influence, and apparently they do, they can influence the designation of branch managers.
In the case of Ms. Deguito, as I said in the last hearing, we receive resumes all the time, 50 to 100 a year. We pass it on to the business heads, and then the hiring process goes through a vetting process, Your Honor.
Yes, okay, that's fine. But apparently in this case, the vetting process was overridden by a recommendation of an outsider. Okay, that's established already, Mr. Tan.
I don't think that happened here, Your Honor. I mean, we don't do it that way in RCBC. We have a very professional organization. I think in the case of Ms. Deguito, the impression was she had a lot of business in East West, and she can bring in. And I think she committed to bringing in substantial amounts of business, and I think they have emails to prove that. But
okay,
you know,
contradicted Mr. Raul Tan, who said that it was upon the recommendation. But at any rate, let's not go into this. He said, she said, argument. Ms. Deguito, is there anything you want to say here? In the hearing, open hearing, about what you know about Jason Go.
Sir, I apologize, but I'll do it in the executive session, Your Honor.